Here we go. Let's now learn to stop all these aerial attacks we have personally been equipped with. Now, here's the thing with defense. It's very situational. Depending on the game mode, the boost, situations, the pressure, the strategy, there's many things that can change. However, we need some base to go off of that should work in most situations. I want to give a huge shout out to the Raidmeister for helping me with this one and helping me make it super concise. His links are below. Check him out. He sometimes streams, and when he does, it's extremely high level gameplay with a chilled atmosphere. Really, really sick. We're going to break defending down into ones, twos, and threes today, and we're going to start with 1v1. Basically, in ones, your default should be to challenge straight away when the opponent is going airborne, if you have the boost and positioning to do so. This way, you force them to at least have to outplay you. The goal here is to get some sort of touch or 50-50. If you don't challenge, it leaves you susceptible to being bumped. And even if you do make the save, because you're defending in a reactive manner, you will probably land inside the goal and not be able to transition to your offense, meaning the opponent will pressure you and boost starve you. But what if you're already in that situation? Let's say you waited too long, or you didn't have a good position or boost to challenge with, and now you're in this reactive defensive zone. All right, let me give you some advice. Calm down, okay? Calm down. Be smarter with your challenges. Have a backup plan. Do not go diving in and wasting all your boost. Get solid 50-50s until you can break out of defense. Save your boost. Grab the pads when you can. Use wave dashes and flips if necessary. In a situation where you're shadowing and the opponent has gone at the wall, you can either go straight up if you have the boost. Or you can go to the backboard shadow with the intention of jumping off if it's going to be dangerous. Or if they're going high, you can go off the ceiling and challenge. This way you get a flip. Additionally, we want to mix up our challenge timing. Sometimes as soon as they get their first touch, we dive in. Sometimes we will shadow and wait. If you've ever played against someone like this, it's so frustrating because when you think you can control the ball, they challenge instantly. And other times, you will smash the ball away because you expected them to challenge. So this can prevent the opponent going up from good angles with a solid first touch because they don't have the confidence that you're not challenging. And when they do try and get a good first touch, you've challenged them. It's horrible to play against. Waiting on the ground when the opponent is up should only be used when you have low boost. But you should still try and get some hype, either off the backboard, a squishy save with no boost, or even using the sides of the goal to jump off. If you have seen that the opponent has an aerial that doesn't look dangerous because they messed it up, then there is no need to jump up. In this situation, we can wait on the ground and wait for them to drop so we can get the 50 and get the ball back. This also saves boost. When defending aerial plays, a good tip is to try and read the opponent's car language, looking at the way their car is positioned before the shot is taken rather than looking at the ball can give you hints to where they're trying to play it. And you can pre-jump that general area and get a touch to make the save if you choose to defend reactively. Twos. In twos, there's two positions you can be in. You can either be the first man or the second man. And the easiest way to figure that one out, to which one you are, is to see who has the best momentum going to the ball and is the closest. If your teammate is closer to the ball, they are the first man, unless you see them clearly rotating. And then they are transitioning to become the second man as you become the first man. Okay, so as the first man, your job is to outplay the attacker, to either allow the second man to have a free challenge, or guide the ball into the corners for your second man to pick it up. Remember the 50-50 guide about inside challenging? This can help force this situation. But under no circumstances, this is the big point. If you take nothing else away from this video, just take this away. Do not leave your second man in a 2v1. This tends to be the biggest reason goals get scored in ranks under, well, pretty much in all ranks actually. 2v1s are a death sentence. So how do we prevent leaving our teammate in a 2v1 besides the inside challenge? Well, don't dive too early as the first man. For example, diving into the opponent's back corners or at midfield when there is no backup. These are the most important parts. You must be aware of your teammate. You're probably thinking, hold on, Dave, are you saying twos is a team mode and not a chance for me to get some nice clips while leaving my teammate in a 2v1 under loads of pressure while I've got no boost at the back? Yes. Yes, I am. Look to see where your teammate is. Use your camera. Press it in if you want to look behind you. See if he's back, and if he is, don't dive early. Shadow instead as the first man to bring the play closer to your second man. Doing this usually makes the attacker flick because they will expect the challenge, allowing the second man to come in and take the ball. If the second man is too far back, you can guide the ball into the corner for the second man. If your teammate is right behind you, then it's more acceptable to dive in earlier, knowing that your teammate can back you up. Twos is about backing each other up, not running off downfield for a 720 redirect most of the time. However, that was more aimed at a grounded opponent. What about aerial? In the situation, the opponent is aerialing, as first man, go. Go up, get a challenge, be proactive, go straight away if they're close to your net. It goes without saying, if they are doing a pointless aerial where they're just hitting it onto the sidewall, just wait for them to throw the ball away, and then you can go and get the ball and attack, and this could actually put your opponents in a 2v1 situation. The worst thing you can do in twos is to both sit there in net whilst getting attacked. This causes the rotation to become congested, and usually with semi-decent finishes, a goal is imminent. So if you've got boost and you're first, get up in the air when in danger. If you see your teammate hesitating there first and you got boost, just go up. Because if they don't go, you're going to be scored on pretty much quite often nowadays because people are so good at double touches. If you're not in danger, be smart, shadow, bring the play to the corner for the counter. Freeze. Well, freeze is similar to twos, but usually can be a little bit more liberal as the first man, looking to challenge and keep the pressure. That being said, you are still a team and you need to attack as so. So now we add in a third position, and this is the last man. If you are the last man, as we rotate in a circle, you should be going from first to last position, come in round to the back post. And now you got to use your camera again to see what's going on. If you see your second man on the backboard, you should expect him to handle anything going that high. So you should sit on the ground. If your second man is on the ground, you should go to the backboard. But again, it's all about reading the game. For example, if we are the third man, we're rotating back, and we see our second man is on the backboard. Our first man is challenging the play, but they are running a telegraph passing play where one player is in the mid waiting for the pass. In this situation, it's your job to go and intercept this pass as you're the only one who can get there early. However, if the pass has already happened, then in this situation, you should be waiting at the back post for a save. So there you have it, defense in a nutshell. Now, some of you may be sat there thinking, but what's he on about rotating in circles? Do not worry, as we now understand defense, we are going to learn each mode individually over the next 3 weeks. And then we have the final challenge for the black belt in the fundamental system. As always, everyone, thank you so much for watching. I hope this helped. Have a nice life, look after yourself, and peace out.
Peace.